Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss the stability analysis of cantilever retaining wall from the chapter Earth Pressure Theory. In short, in this video, we are going to discuss different forces which are acting on the retaining wall. So suppose this is the cantilever retaining wall. Then the forces acting on the retaining wall will be, the first force is self weight of the retaining wall. The second pressure is active pressure towards the backfill side. The third pressure will be passive pressure. This pressure will act from the direction where cantilever retaining wall is supposed to move. And the fourth pressure will be the weight of soil above base slab. So the soil which is present above the base slab will have its weight, which will act on the base slab. So this weight will try to resist the overturning. So in this video, we are going to discuss how these forces affect the stability, and knowing the value of these forces, we are going to do the stability analysis, stability check of the retaining wall. But before that, let us discuss first the general proportions for the different dimensions of the retaining wall. So here in this figure, we can see a cantilever retaining wall of height h. It retains a soil backfill having surcharge angle I. That means the surface of the backfill is inclined at an angle I with the horizontal. The top width of the stem for this retaining wall should be at least 0.3 meter, so that it will allow the proper placement of the concrete during construction. The width of the base slab is generally kept equal to 2/3 of the total height of the cantilever retaining wall. The width of the stem at the bottom, means this width, and the thickness of this base slab are kept equal to h by 10, means it should be equal to 0.1 into height. And also the distance, horizontal distance between the stem and the toe should be equal to at least h by 10. And the slope of the surface of the stem towards the toe side should be at least 30:1. The earth pressure acting on the retaining wall is computed using Rankine's theory. So as per this theory, the active earth pressure acts along the vertical line AB. So this vertical line AB passes through heel point A. But for that, a condition should be satisfied. And the condition is, this line AC, which is shown as a dotted line, should not be obstructed by the stem of the retaining wall. So as we have seen in the Rankine's earth pressure theory, the shape of the retaining wall was like this. So here line AC represents this back of the retaining wall in Rankine's earth pressure theory. So this line AC should not be obstructed by the stem of the retaining wall, so that this entire portion will resemble to the cross section of retaining wall in Rankine's earth pressure theory. So here, angle made by this line AC with the horizontal is alpha, whereas angle made by the back of the retaining wall in Rankine's theory with the horizontal was also alpha, and angle made by line AC with the vertical is eta. So we have already discussed the formula for alpha and eta in previous video. So here the active pressure acting on the back of the retaining wall is obtained by using Rankine's formula, which is Pa is equal to Ka gamma H for cohesionless soil. So here Ka is equal to cos I into cos I minus under root of cos square I minus cos square phi dash divided by cos I plus under root of cos square I minus cos square phi dash. So using this formula we can obtain the value of active pressure for cohesionless soils. So this active pressure obtained is inclined at an angle I with the horizontal. That means this active pressure acting at the back of the retaining wall is parallel to the top surface of the backfill. So this active pressure Pa can be resolved into two components: vertical components Pv and horizontal component Ph. Now there is another force acting on the retaining wall, which is passive pressure Pp. So this passive pressure Pp is obtained by formula Pp equal to Kp gamma H. So here Kp is the coefficient of passive pressure. So value of Kp obtained as is obtained as cos I into cos I plus under root of cos square I minus cos square phi dash divided by cos I minus under root of cos square I minus cos square phi dash. So using these two formula we can obtain the value of passive earth pressure Pp. And there are another forces which are acting. The next force is weight of the retaining wall. It is denoted as Wc. So weight of retaining wall Wc, and the weight of the soil present above the stem should also be considered for the equilibrium condition. So this weight of the soil above base slab is considered and it is suppose equal to Ws. So here we have listed out the forces acting on this retaining wall. So these forces are vertical component of active earth pressure Pv, horizontal component of active earth pressure Ph, the passive earth pressure, weight of the retaining wall and weight of the soil above the base slab. So these are the forces which are going to affect the stability of the retaining wall. So now we have listed out different forces acting on the retaining wall and we have highlighted these forces in this diagram. So these forces are vertical component of active pressure, horizontal component of active pressure, the passive pressure, weight of the retaining wall and weight of the soil which is above the base slab. So now we will discuss different factor of safety. So first we will see factor of safety against sliding. So factor of safety against sliding is given by formula Fs is equal to summation of Fr divided by summation of Fd. So here Fr is the sum of horizontal resisting force and Fd is the sum of horizontal driving force. Since sliding is taking in horizontal direction, taking place in horizontal direction, Hence, we will consider horizontal forces only. So, since sliding of the retaining wall is considered, so two more forces will also be coming into picture. So, first force is cohesive force. It is acting at the base of the retaining wall. So, total cohesive force will be equal to C into B. So, C is the cohesion per unit length and B is the total breadth of the retaining wall. The another force which will come into picture is the force of friction between the retaining wall and underlying soil. So, this force of friction will be equal to summation of V into tan phi. Here summation V is the sum of all the vertical forces. So here vertical forces are WC, WS and PV. And phi is the angle of frictional resistance. So here FR is the sum of horizontal resisting forces. So the resisting forces are cohesive force, friction and this passive pressure. So these three forces will resist the sliding of the retaining wall towards the left side, means away from the back field. So the summation of these three forces, that is cohesive force, frictional force and passive force, will be equal to FR. So we can write FR as summation of V tan phi plus CB plus PP, passive pressure. And here the horizontal component of active pressure try to cause the sliding. So it will be considered as the equal to FD, because FD is the sum of horizontal driving force. So PH is the only driving force. Summation of tan phi plus BC plus PP divided by PH. So here summation of V is the sum of all vertical forces, which are WC, WS and PV. B is the base width. PP is the passive force, as we have discussed. So in case of cohesive soil, PP is given by this formula. And for cohesion less soil, PP will be equal to half KP gamma D only, because this term will become 0. And C, gamma and phi are the parameters of the soil. So C is the cohesion, gamma is the density and phi is the angle of internal friction. So the factor of safety for the retaining wall should be at least 1.5. And if this required factor of safety is not obtained, the base key is provided just below the stem. So below the stem, a base key is provided. So because of this base key, the passive earth pressure will increase and the resulting factor of safety will also increase. That means this base key increases the passive resistance of the retaining wall. So now we will discuss factor of safety against overturning. So this factor of safety is denoted as FO and it is equal to summation of MR divided by summation of MO. So here summation of MR is equal to sum of resisting moment about toe and MO is the sum of overturning moment about toe. Now let us see in this figure. Here the force PH causes the anti-clockwise movement and this force PV tries to cause clockwise movement. Here WS is also tries to cause clockwise movement about toe, and here weight of the retaining wall also tries to cause the clockwise movement. So here WC, WS and PV, these forces try to cause the clockwise movement about toe, means they try to resist the overturning moment. And here pH is the only force which try to cause anti-clockwise movement. So it is the driving force, means this force tries to overturn the retaining wall. So pH is the only overturning force and it acts at height of h by 3. So overturning moment will be equal to pH into h by 3. So here resisting forces are PV, WS and WC, which is weight of the retaining wall. So let us assume movement due to PV is MV. Now in order to calculate movement due to WS, we will divide the area which is above the base slab into two equal portions. So first portion is this triangular portion. So these areas are divided because we can easily calculate the weight of the soil in these regions and hence we can easily calculate the movement. So movement due to area 1 will be equal to M1. Movement due to area 2 will be equal to M2. Similarly, we have divided cross section of the retaining wall into 3 parts. The one part is named as or numbered as 3. So movement due to this rectangular portion which is numbered at 3 is M3. And another part is this triangular portion which is numbered as 4. So movement due to this portion is M4. And the last portion is the portion of this base slab. It is numbered as 5. So movement due to this portion about toe is M5. So these are the resisting moments. So FO is equal to sum of the resisting moment. So FO will be equal to M1 M plus M2 plus M3 plus M4 plus M5 plus MV, that is movement due to PV, divided by resisting force, movement due to resisting force, which is equal to pH into h by 3. So this is the formula to determine the factor of safety against overturning. So here we can see that M1, M2, M3, M4 and M5 are the moments due to weight of the soil W1, W2, W3, W4 and W5 in the region of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 respectively. Now we will discuss the third factor of safety, which is factor of safety against bearing capacity failure. So here in this diagram, the vertical forces are WC, WS and PV. So the force acting at the base is equal to summation of V. So summation of V is equal to WC plus WS plus PV. And the horizontal force is the pH. So the resultant R is given by formula. R is equal to under root of summation of V square plus summation of pH square. So this is the formula for resultant of all these four forces. Now the net moment of these forces about toe point E, that means about this point, is given by summation of M equal to summation of MR, that means summation of resisting moment, minus summation of MO, that is summation of overturning moment. We have already discussed the formula for MR and MO. So in previous slide, summation of MR is equal to M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4 plus M5. These are the area of retaining wall, movement due to retaining wall and movement due to soil above the base slab, plus MV. This is the movement due to PV. And MO is equal to summation of MO is equal to pH into h by 3. So the net moment of these forces summation m is equal to summation of mr minus summation of mo. So the distance x bar from the point E from where the resultant r strikes is given by x bar equal to summation of m divided by summation of v. Hence, the eccentricity of the r is given by E equal to b by 2 minus x bar. Suppose we have obtained x bar. So, this is the distance x bar. So, here resultant due to this vertical and horizontal forces strike the base. So, this distance is x bar. The center of the base of the retaining wall is here. So, the eccentricity is the distance between the point where resultant strikes and the center of the base. So, E will be equal to this distance, which is b by 2 minus x bar. If value of E is greater than b by 6, the section should be changed because it indicates the tension. The pressure distribution under the base slab is determined from the formula P max equal to summation of V by B into 1 plus 6 E by B, and P min is equal to summation of B into 1 minus 6 E upon B. So, the formula for factor of safety against bearing is obtained as FB is equal to QNA divided by P max. So, here QNA is the maximum allowable bearing capacity and Pmax is the value which is obtained from this formula. It is the maximum pressure due to eccentricity E and the applied forces. Thank you for watching.